I started printing photographs in 1990 when I was 15 in high school. I made pictures and printed them, and I lived in Dublin for a couple of years in the 90s. And then following that, I went to art school around 2000 in Victorian College of the Arts, which is a part of now the University of Melbourne. I had lived in Melbourne for a few years previously in that part of Australian Victoria. So, and then following that, I was teaching for a couple of years while practicing, and then eventually moved back to the UK, initially to Bristol. So during that time, we were part of setting up the Bristol Biennial, which was an artist-led festival. I participated in the Format Photography Festival, which is in Derby. And then coming out of that, I did a short residency at the Fire Station in Dublin, after that relocated to Cork. But all the while, doing the usual group shows. I had an exhibition at the Sirius Arts Centre in 2015 called Arcadian Grey, and I was invited to be part of EVA International for a work called Adornamento. And at the moment I run a dark room in Cork as part of the Backwater Artist Group, where we have a few members, and I teach at the Crawford College of Art and Design. I was trained as a film photographer, and yet in my training I was in an art school which had a really good balance of concept and technique. Looking at, you know, the gear chosen for this project, the large format cameras, particularly there's an extremely high resolution. And the camera itself is flexible in the sense that it can be moved into different configurations, and they change focus and the perspective seen in the shot for the viewer. But in choosing particular gear, I don't like to fetishize it, you know, I mean, for me it's a means of making the work, and in the end I often will digitize images made on film, and those images may be manipulated afterwards in post. Well, I think that, you know, technology is ubiquitous. Like, we live in an age where there's been huge changes to the medium that I use, and that has an impact. You know, the camera phone, I kind of see it almost like as a way of scanning the world. So there's, you know, the idea that, you know, go back to someone like Ansel Adams, which everyone saw as the crusty American technical, you know, almost dictator. And people in the postmodernist period were always reacting against him. But, you know, use that expression, you know, you don't take a photograph, you make it. And this kind of the idea of consciousness and the choice that you make a picture by constructing it rather than necessarily accidentally scanning the world. I grew up in Sligo town, and you know, Leitrim for me as a child, you know, I lived here till the age of about 12, was a place that was full of these trees. And so driving through this sort of landscape, which was kind of always kind of a romantic experience for me, I had no real kind of connection with the reality of it. It was just a perspective. So I guess approaching the commission, I was looking at making images which would bridge the gap, show elements that were very beautiful and iconic, related in some way to tourism imagery. You know, I think the purpose of the work is to entice the viewer to keep looking, but to find in the images things that could be problematic. I approach any project to do with landscape with that kind of concern or caution. It doesn't necessarily impede me from making decisions, but it does make me consider the implications of what I am accessing and how that will be ultimately, you know, represented in the final artwork. I guess researching really, and this is a work in progress as well, so kind of researching into the historical decisions that had been made with regards to land management, you know, the initial seeming push in the 1960s for this type of plantation forest to be introduced. And then I guess a growing awareness over time of the impact of the damage of that. So yeah, I think the approach really with the work is to consider that it is a complex issue. At least from my perspective, I don't feel as an artist that I need to solve a problem or be a politician. I need to respond to what I see in front of me. And, you know, even those Sitka spruce trees can be beautiful. It's just the impact of them creates a fair bit of ugliness as well. So I try and keep all of those things in mind. They can overlap in the work. There can be aspects of beauty and then aspects of a kind of a more objective or critical view. Yeah, being an artist, well, it means job instability, but a great deal of satisfaction. I think the main thing for me is the ability to communicate. And some people will communicate with words and text, and I communicate with imagery. And I think artists are kind of, they can be curious, in a sense, you know, often reclusive or semi-reclusive people who decide to put their work out on display to a mass audience. So it's a curious place to be, you know, but we do it to ourselves, and it's hugely enjoyable at times, so, yeah.